XFM News. On point.
Take a look at the news. The Minister of State for Planning, David Bahati, has assured members of Parliament and the Parliament's Committee of the National Economy that the planned domestic borrowing will not have a severe impact on the economy. Government earlier this month asked Parliament to allow them borrow 6.4 trillion shillings, with 4 trillion shillings expected to be borrowed from the domestic market. However, when the Deputy Governor, Michael Atingi, and Private Sector Foundation appeared before the committee last week, they showed their discomfort with government's decision to borrow domestically, saying it might affect the economy. Bahati now says even though the economy might be affected, the impact will not be as severe because some of the money is going to be used to clear domestic arrears, which are trade-related, and this can stimulate the economy.
So our priority are really trade-related domestic areas, and that's what we are doing. So on the overall, and I know that those private people and the Bank of Uganda did not put into consideration the broader picture of the economy. They were focusing on themselves. On the overall, this borrowing will not impact, the negative impact of this borrowing will not be as severe as people are expecting. No.
Bahati assured the committee that the hesitation by commercial banks to lend to the private sector is not in any way related to government's decision to borrow domestically, adding that government has already allocated money to Uganda Development Bank through which private sector can use.
The reason why the interest rate, and we are working on this, is increasing and has stayed stuck in the between 19% and the 24%, it's not because the government is borrowing. It's because of the structure nature of our liberalized economy that the commercial banks, actually Bank of Uganda, has actually very little at control the interest rate apart from indirect policy measures.
Alliance for National Transformation will focus on health and economic transformation when voted into power during the general elections. In a press conference held today at the party headquarters, and presidential flag bearer General Mugisha Muntu has highlighted key areas in their manifesto, such as improving security and standards of living for security personnel, providing free health care and insurance to all Ugandans, boosting the agricultural sector, among others. Muntu says the country has enough resources to facilitate such activities, but only lacks the right people in the right positions.
Ugandans, don't follow emotions. We are human beings, we have emotions. It is easy for us to get emotionally sucked in this situation, and we just, voting people maybe whom we like, or maybe, we don't vote against, emotions can lead us to make choices which eventually may even be counter to the interest that we desire. So we need you to look at all of us, do analysis of us, and look for a team of people that you believe have got the abilities and the discipline and the will and the understanding of the situation, and therefore become effective responses to the challenges that you do have.
The Ministry of Health has received 3 ambulances procured with support from United Nations Children's Fund and financial assistance from the government of Sweden. The ambulances will be deployed in Pakwach, Madiokolo and Obongi district local governments in the West Nile region to support timely referral and transportation of women and children with complications to health facilities. According to UNICEF, communities, especially those in hard-to-reach areas, continue to experience delays in accessing health facilities in a timely manner, including lack of funds to pay for transport, poor road infrastructure and poor communication networks, putting more mothers and their babies to risk. The acting UNICEF representative to Uganda, Shadrach Omolo, emphasized that the focus on addressing transport barriers, especially in the face of COVID-19, is timely. Dr. Diana Twine, Permanent Secretary, Minister of Health, said the ambulances will reach many more mothers and children in need of health care services. Police has warned politicians against cheap politics where some promise the impossible. The PROCID Charles Twiney says instead of presenting the manifestos, some politicians have gone beyond and started telling lies which may cause problems.
We want to request the political players to present ideas to the members of public to present programs and ideology. They should stop the rhetorics and the bombastic campaigns to the extent that others have started even promising the incomprehensible things. So when you start promising us salaries, that is cheap politics.
In other news, South Africa's Department of Home Affairs has said that they have started the process of deporting 20 migrants, mostly from African countries, who were part of a months-long protest against xenophobia. The protest began in October 2019 in Cape Town, near the city and outside the offices of the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees. They were demanding to be relocated to a third country outside South Africa and didn't want to return to their countries of origin. They said they were experiencing poor treatment and discrimination and no longer felt safe in South Africa after a surge of xenophobic attacks in the country's townships. South Africa's Home Affairs Department has said the deportation of 20 migrants followed due process and was confirmed by the court earlier this week. More migrants are expected to be deported. That was the news.
XFM News. On point.